I recently got a lot of questions about JPA 3.0, and since EclipseLink and Hibernate now offer full support for it, it's time to take a closer look at the latest update of the specification. As part of the transformation from Java EE to Jakarta EE, the Java Persistence API was renamed to Jakarta Persistence API. The first step of that process happened with JPA 2.2 and was now completed with JPA 3.0. Let's take a closer look at the changes introduced in JPA 3.0 and the required migration steps. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen with another video about building incredibly efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring. Make sure to subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. If you take a closer look at JPA 3.0, it might seem like nothing has changed, and that's not entirely wrong. JPA 3.0 brings no new features. It only changes the prefix of all API classes' package names, the prefix of some configuration properties, and the schema namespaces for all XML-based configuration files. The goal of these changes was to replace the word Java to avoid legal issues. The prefix of the package names and configuration parameter names changes from javax.persistence to jakarta.persistence. For example, the import required for the entity annotation changes from JavaX persistence entity to Jakarta persistence entity. And the name of the JavaX persistence schema generation database action property changes to Jakarta persistence schema generation database action. In addition to that, the URL of the XML schemata changed, as you can see here on the slide. These changes complete the transition process from Java EE to Jakarta EE. Unfortunately, they also require you to migrate your code and configuration files. The two most popular implementations of the JPA specification support version 3.0. If you want to use EclipseLink, you need to use at least version 3.0. Hibernate started to support JPA 3.0 with version 5.5. All Hibernate artifacts that support the new JPA 3.0 APIs have the suffix Jakarta in their name. If you still want to use the old APIs, you can stick to the old artifact names. After you updated your dependencies to one of the ones listed on the previous slide, you need to make a few changes to your import statements and configuration files. But don't worry, it's not as bad as it might seem. You can do most of the work using the search and replace feature in your IDE or by executing a few basic commands on the command line. Let's start with the package names. As mentioned earlier, JPA 3.0 didn't add or change any functionality compared to JPA 2.2. It only changed the package from JavaX persistence to Jakarta persistence. Due to that, you can simply replace all occurrences of import JavaX persistence with import Jakarta persistence. After you did that, the imports of your entity classes should look like this, and all your mapping definitions should be unchanged. If you're using an oim.xml or persistence.xml file to define your mapping or configure your persistence unit, you should also update the namespace and schema definitions. Here you can see the required change for a persistence.xml file. And if I would use an oim.xml file in this project, I should use this namespace. The last thing you need to do to migrate your application to JPA 3.0 is to update the names of your configuration parameters. These are usually defined and used in your persistence.xml file, and I explained all of them in great detail in my beginner's guide to JPA's persistence.xml. You can find a link to it in the video description below. The name of some of these properties includes the prefix JavaX persistence, for example, JavaX persistence JDBC driver. For all of these parameters, you need to replace JavaX persistence with Jakarta persistence. After you did that, your configuration looks similar to this. And that's all you need to do. As I said earlier, it's not as bad as it might seem in the beginning. JPA 3.0 changed the packages of all classes, the XML namespaces of the configuration files, and the names of some configuration parameters to complete the transition from the Java Persistence API to the Jakarta Persistence API. Especially the change of the package names might look like a huge change that causes a lot of work in existing projects. But it's not as bad as it seems. You can easily change the import statements using your IDE search and replace feature or a basic shell script.
Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like cheat sheets and ebooks on how to use JPA and Hibernate more efficiently and avoid common performance pitfalls. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!